Hello, everybody. Sorry, first time doing this, getting all set up. How's everyone doing? We are working on the perfect grade, Unicorn, today. And this is going to be my first time streaming for you guys, besides the Bawu build, my first personal stream. So, without further ado, just gonna put that right there, because that is the base for this monster. And I'm just gonna start working. Talk about an action base. Yeah, it is quite big, and it's the first step they have in the manual. I think you knew that, Jeremy. Because how this kit works is because of the LEDs, you gotta work on the base first, put all the wiring in there, and then work your way up. Alright, first runner down. That didn't take very long. Set this aside for a minute. So, some of you may know me as Blue Mist from the chat. But I also go by Jimmy, in case you're wondering. And I'm fine either way. Whatever you want to call me is fine. Three more to go. Yeah, I use Gundam Planet nippers, Jeremy. They're pretty good. I recommend them. Smooth as butter. the LED wires, they come in sections, and
I can actually show you like the actual like
thing that came in like the box for it. They come in all these different like bags, and they're all labeled in different letters based on what part they go in. And then there's like the battery pack over here, and I don't know what else is all this, but this one's also labeled. And they apparently have a prying tool in there too, for you to use when you're actually installing the LEDs, because I guess you have to get in some tight places with them. And I heard they can be quite tricky to get into the perfect grid. Yeah, I was looking at the instructions for the legs earlier, and I'm not looking very forward to that. That seems like a process. But I'm very excited about this kit. My first perfect grade of all time. Man, everyone's getting perfect grades. I mean, you were looking at the red frame though the other day. I wouldn't mind getting a perfect grade red frame if I didn't already have the mastery in my backlog. I actually haven't seen Stargazer or I forgot what the show is with the asteroids in it, what that one was called, but I need to get around to watching that, because I do like the asteroid design quite a bit. I mean, doesn't a Zazabi count as a perfect grade, Jeremy? It's almost the same size. Oh no. The perfect grade RX-78. Everyone is getting perfect grades, I'm sorry, Jeremy. I would really love to get a a perfect grade freedom. That would be really sick. Although, I think I would want to paint it though. Maybe, I don't know. To the Google Mobile. The Master Grade O is pretty insane. I was also eyeballing it, but I wasn't sure for a Master Grade $80 was a good price. Seems a little bit expensive to me. Oh, just realized the side of the stand looks like the unicorn horn. That's actually really cool. I didn't know that. Excellent touch, Bandai. I'm impressed. Yeah, paying attention to detail is a must on a perfect grade, because I heard that if parts don't align, like, exactly on the perfect grade, it's going to cause you trouble. Perfect grades don't mess around. Oh, I see. There's like a little track on the back for the wires to go through on the back of the kit. I'm already spotting things. Alright. And then I gotta insert the battery pack for the LEDs. Wow, that clicked. I don't know what I clicked, but it clicked. Oh man, there's wire threading involved in the bottom of this thing. plate for the battery pack. And what's actually pretty smart about this is, if you didn't use the LEDs on the perfect grade, the cover comes with the main kit, but the battery pack only comes in the LEDs.
So they include the cover for the base.
And whether you use the LEDs or not, this cover goes on. It's just whether you flip it around is what happens, whether you have the LED or if you have the standard build. And then what do you guys think about the new music that I got going? Because I found a royalty-free website that does tracks, like beats. And I quite liked it. So I made a playlist from all the free tracks they hand out. This perfect grade's already confusing me. Yeah, I don't know what you'd call this. I guess the stem for the action base, it extends so that, whether you want to do like a slight flying pose or if you want to do a standing pose. And there's different levels in there. So I have to play around, see what I like. Fighting me. There it goes. supposed to be sticking out like that? I see. There we go. That is tight. Okay. I know for a fact that I want to have them in unicorn mode instead of the destroy mode, because I have the master grade unicorn. But I have that one in unicorn mode because I actually kind of prefer that mode, but you can't have a perfect grade and not have it in the destroy mode. That would be insane. Although, with the LEDs, the unicorn mode does look cool as well. So I don't know. Like, I'm just gonna have to repose it, I think, every now and then until I find something I like. Bark, 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 bark. Yeah, dogs sometimes just bark at nothing. Annoying. Arf, arf. So right now I'm just trying to thread this LED strip through a channel, I guess, that's smaller than the actual wire. So I'm having to feed it in. And there's a bend here and I don't like that. Okay, I think I got it. Okay, moving on. Next page. Oh, that's it? Well, I guess the stand's done.
So now that I can go over here. And
yeah, Jeremy, you're right. That weighs a lot.
The base already is. It weighs quite a bit, and it doesn't even have four batteries in it yet.
Because the LEDs run off of four AA's. I never really reposed my kits either, but this is a perfect grade. Do it for the perfect grade. Oh, don't go off again.
Yeah, good luck finding runners with the perfect grade.
Okay, one second. Okay, dog stop finally. Yeah, I literally have all the runners on my bed at the moment.
And it takes up about half my bed in just plastic. I'm not sure whether I'm impressed or
sad about that.
And what I've gotten myself into.
Oh, off stream you worked on the Vidar? Pixar didn't happen. I feel like I want to go back and paint the pilot, Benazir, in the cockpit, but at the same time, I kind of don't want to have to take apart the cockpit if I don't have to on a perfect grid. And also, I hear this kit's arms are not the best when it comes to holding its weapons it comes with. Because I think the weapons and the joints are just too heavy to be able to get any dynamic poses out of the kit. Even do that right? No, I didn't. Please, not again. Oh, that's cool. This is also a pry bar that they include. Because I'm gonna need it. Because I already messed up on where something needs to go. Because this is pretty confusing, because they have two different types of polycaps that they're trying to use. In the hip, for some reason. And one's a different type of material than the other one, and it's a really tight fit. Right. The fact that the Perfect Grape's leg is as tall as the MG's. I believe it. It might take me 2 or 3 stream sessions just to do the legs, I think. They're a little bit crazy. Seem to find a runner.
Although I saw it earlier. There it is.
Oh man. That was me just finding one runner for one piece. I need to try to organize these a little bit better next time. Although it doesn't help in the step, it needs a runner from like everything. I have to say the nubs on this kit is really nice, actually, where they put them. They're not in very obvious spots. So cleanup is a breeze. But I'm also noticing there's a lot of detailing to do. Hence the name Perfect Grade, I suppose. I'm gonna try doing some panel wash because this piece looks prime for the detailing. Because it's just got panel lines all over it. Gotta make sure the panel wash is mixed though. Got some thinner over here. I learned that the panel wash is actually really nice, and it's a lot faster in cases like this where there's a lot of detail in a small area. It's just easier just to dab it a few times with the panel wash and then just clean it up after, rather than just going over everything with the pen and then trying to rub the pen away. What's the new IBO high grade kit? It isn't a new Barbatos, is it? Oh wow, that's quite a bit different than what they've been releasing as far as IBO goes. That's actually really cool. That isn't another Gundam frame, is it? Thank you. Alright. Pilot safely tucked in there like a yoke. Safely. Oh, except I missed a step. I feel like that's gonna be a common trend with the perfect grade. Missing steps and then having to go back. Perfect grade right now. I don't see any hope of this thing coming out. You bastards. They actually put hooks in that piece. That's why I couldn't pry it apart. They have it hooked in there. Gee. They really don't want this thing disassembled, I guess. Sneaky Bondi. Oh, that's interesting. They got the cockpit to rotate inside of the chest. as my first perfect grade, the reason why I chose the unicorn, I feel like it's probably one of the best perfect grades we have at the moment. To me, at least. I don't know. It has, like, the transformation gimmick, and then it has all the LEDs. And plus, I really like the unicorn quite a bit. Because I did enjoy unicorn. But I would love to get, like, a RX-70, or...
A Mark II?
Yeah. I would like a Mark II. Perfect grade. Either the Titan's color or the AU color, but I'll settle with the Master Grade for right now. And then I was saying earlier, I would have really liked the Freedom Gundam Perfect Grade. My perfect grade brings all the boys to the yard. claims to paint a streamed kit. Probably not for me, considering painting a kit takes a while to do. And right now, I have to airbrush outside because I don't have a means of getting the fumes out of the house at the moment. Talking about 00 kits over there. Yeah, masking is a pain when painting. It takes forever to do, but the effort is not wasted usually, as long as the masking tape does its job. You usually get really, really good results if you put in the time. I have some liquid masking I wanted to use on my Sinanju Master Grade. Whenever I get around to doing that. But the gold pieces all over that require stickers. Yeah, stickers, no bueno. I just looked at him and I was like, no, I'd rather not. Oh, that was a snap. But a good snap. That's pretty dope, actually. Torso doesn't really move like I thought it was right here. The cockpit moves a bit, though. But I'm already getting some of the transformation gimmick going on. That's cool. Look at all these polycaps. Yeah, reverse washing is quite an annoying thing to do. I was looking into that before. I think I would prefer going the liquid masking route to do those. Oh. Sorry guys, I had to find runner Q. Q. I'm up to the Q's. Q is for questionable at the amount of runners this kit has. Like TriStar Zaku. Oh yeah, you're going all in on that paint job. Oh boy. Yeah, they look good though. Work. Well, that piece is out of here. I don't know why, but they seem to have two different types of polycaps. They have like a harder, more plastic type, and then they have a normal type of polycap, and they're putting like two on each side of each joint. It's kind of weird, but I guess whatever helps hold pegs in on the kit. The custom Buzz Lightyear. I am curious if someone has done it before. Disney would hire you if you made a perfect grade.
Buzz Lightyear.
I would like to hope they would. Someone's getting taken out for a walk, and the other ones don't like it. Nah, Disney would sue. Probably. Perfect green blue frame. Oh man, what if someone like did a kit bash of like the 7-Eleven Astray perfect grade? I think they did that, right? And then get like a perfect grade red frame and the blue frame, and then just mix all the frame up so you get like a multicolored Astray. That'd be pretty cool. Wow, I am having a hard time getting this piece in. It doesn't want to thread where it needs to thread. Got it. Finally. One. Don't use gray on white. You come to the wrong neighborhood. That gif. I love dodgeball. You catch a wrench, you can catch a ball. What? How? I remember seeing Dodgeball when it came out in theaters. That was a good movie. I vote on backpack, because it seems like something that you'd see less of. Gives you something to warm up on. Oh yeah. It's the head HD is a friend of mine who came to stop by the stream, I guess. Although I don't need his support. Good. That's not good. I didn't check to make sure the lid was off. Uh-oh. Check to make sure your bottles are closed, kids. wasted perfectly good panel lining. Using a Mr. Color leveling thinner, although using lighter fluid would probably be a better idea. It's just what I have right now, because the stuff is kind of expensive, because I want to use that thinner for airbrushing and not the panel line liquid. Yeah, I have some acrylic thinner, but I need to get the enamel thinner. The stuff up is the worst. Oh, I think I got most of it. Okay, this is a big runner. It's like the size of my cutting mat, holy cow. That is one heck of a torso. It's actually substantial. But I think this is a good stopping point for me, considering I got panel line wash all over. And I think this is a fairly good place to stop, because I was hoping to get the chest done today, but there's still a lot of things left to do. Like, there's a lot of LED things. It's like a rat's nest in this chest. And then the next time I stream, hopefully I can get some of the feet done, at least. But on that, if you're new here, make sure you follow Reactive. Do that. We'd love to see you and interact with you as we build. And for anyone new here, welcome. And I hope you come back. But I'm gonna call it a night here, guys. Thanks for watching. And I'm gonna see you guys next time.